Well, like I said, that I would like to revisit the judicial pronouncements in India without going through the theoretical way of defining the trade secret and the repercussion or implications of trade secret law, protections in India. Now, first, this is a very interesting case. If you happen to see between American Express Bank Limited and Priya Puri. Now, the court had said that a trade secret can be a formula, a technical know-how, or a peculiar mode or method of business adopted by an employer which is unknown to all. So these observations of court, this gives you the definition of trade secret. Now, then we have a look on the what constitutes as a breach of confidence that is used by the Indian courts to decide whether there has been a misappropriation of trade secret. Information which is generally known will not qualify this first requirement. Then there is must be an obligation of confidence relating to such fact or information. Say, if I share the information, there must be an obligation of confidence between the parties. Then there must be an authorized use of that information to the detriment of the party communicated. Suppose I have confided some information, might be that information is generally can be driven, but I pass on to somebody with a confidence, and then if he unauthorizedly pass on that information or use that information, then it becomes the breach of confidence. So this will also constitute a misappropriation of trade secret. Now suppose someone has to choose between patents versus trade secret. Now, if the issue is what someone has to protect, suppose in patent you can cover new useful invention, wherein in trade secret you cover valuable secret information. Now, what patent gives you the right? Patent gives you the right to exclude others from making, selling, using, or importing a patented product or a process. But in case of trade secret, it protects only against misappropriation of the valuable and secret information. Then, if we come to patent, ultimately the invention becomes public after a certain period of time. But in case of trade secret, it remains secret. Like Coca-Cola has still remained, the formula has still remained secret. Then by patent you get, how do you get a patent? You have to go for filing a formal application, then examination, etc. And it takes time, up to 2 to 3 years on average in India nowadays, but previously it used to take more. But in trade secret, you got the advantage that you don't have to make any application, and the duration of your right is as long as it takes to establish and maintain internal procedures. And this is potentially perpetual. Now, as I said, that India has no specific trade secret law. However, Indian courts, they use the provisions of the following law to decide any case relating to trade secret. What are those laws? Contract law of India, copyright law, the principle of equity, the common law action of breach of contract, actually which amounts to a breach of contractual obligation, and then section 72 of IT Act, Information Technology Act. These are the laws normally Indian courts, they are applying to decide a case on trade secret. Now, here in Richard Brady and Chemical Process Equipment Private Limited, this is a 1987 case. Here, what had happened, the plaintiff had invented a fodder production unit, some device, and he had given certain order for supply of certain thermal panels. Now, whomever he had given to develop those thermal panels, which is required for the fodder production unit. So that fellow was ultimately found that he is not equipped, technically equipped, to supply the or produce the thermal panels. Then the orders were not placed on him. Now here in this case, the question is that whether the defendant's fodder production unit is based on the plaintiff's drawings. The plaintiff, that means the owner of that, he had given somebody to, it's a question of subcontracting, what we call in manufacturing. I have given to subcontract certain components to somebody, and for which I have given my own technical drawings and know-how. Now, if somebody misuses that, now what it tantamounts to, that court took the position that even in the absence of an express confidentiality clause in the contract, confidentiality is implied, and that the defendant is liable for breach of the confidentiality obligation. Now why court had observed that? Because my agreement with my supplier was a purchase agreement or a contract for supply of some product, but there was no specific confidentiality clause was included there. In spite of that, court had decided even if it is not there, it is implied, and the defendant is liable for breach of contract. Now, a second case is that Swayambhar, a reality television show, this was for matchmaking, for marriage. The plaintiff shared a concept note on this with the defendants, and then the plaintiff came across a newspaper report that the defendants were planning to come out with a big budget reality matchmaking show using the plaintiff's concept. Now this is, then court, what when it was the plaintiff sought for an injunction, and court had granted an injunction and held that the concept developed and evolved by the plaintiff was a result of the work done by the plaintiff upon the material which may be available in the public domain. What we learn from here? Say suppose I am doing some business. I am storing or compiling my data, or I am making my book of accounts in a particular way. Now these are the activities, or these data may be a commonly known data. The issue is that I have done it, though these are known, but I have arranged it, or I have used it, I have organized it in a particular way. So in that case, if somebody uses it unauthorizedly, he is liable for damages. So the question is that whether the procedure I use in my business is known. It might be known, maybe 99% of the thing is known. Trade secret is that 1% modification which has given me economic gain and which is new and innovative and creative, that constitutes trade secret. So here you get a kind of a definition of trade secret too. Now this copyright thing, I think she will be talking. Yes, now, and one thing I must say, this is very common here. Section 27 of Indian Contract Act, it provides a framework of rules and regulations governing the formation and performance of a contract in India. It deals with the legality of non-compete covenant and stipulates that an agreement which restrains anyone from carrying on a lawful profession, trade or business is void to that extent.
I told you in UK it is invalid.
What in India is that if I can make a contract with say my employee, but this issue or an agreement, but I cannot restrain anyone from carrying on a lawful profession, trade or business, because even if I make an agreement, that is void. But there are certain exceptions or certain further interpretation by the Indian courts. Now, this is the initial section 20. The law says that you cannot. But what is the interpretation of court? Now, we'll come to that. That it must be, yes, section 27 of the Act implies that to be valid, an agreement in restraint of trade must be reasonable as between the parties and consistent with the interest of public, first thing, and second thing, it should be restricted to particular geographical area and for a reasonable period of time. So that, say, my employee, if he just takes away all my internal data and starts doing something, you know, within that locality, or my employee, he leaves my company and he starts something by taking away my client list or my trade secret, he cannot do it. But he can use his brain, what he have captured during the employment, and can say after a reasonable period of time, after 3 months or 4 months, and he can start his profession in a separate area, geographically separated area, that he can do. That is the interpretation by the court, that you cannot restrain, you cannot ask anybody, no, you go, you have left me, you starve. No, lawful profession he can carry on, but there are certain conditions he has to maintain. This is the last one I want to say. Here, that Homag India versus Ulfat Ali Khan and IMAG Asia Pacific BTA Limited. Now, first, the trial judge, he had a temporary injunction was sought for to restrain the defenders from dealing or transacting in any manner utilizing Homag India's confidential information or trade secret. So when the injunction was sought for in the trial court, the trial judge, he had said, he dismissed the application of for temporary injunction against IMAG. If you carefully look, the injunction was sought for against not Ulfat Ali Khan, but against IMAG Asia Pacific. Now, naturally, trial judge said, he dismissed that he is not a party, that Ulfat Ali Khan was your party or your employee. But IMAG Asia Pacific is a third party. So, injunction can be provided against him. But when the case was again taken up to Karnataka High Court, now Karnataka High Court said that even in absence of a contract between Homag and the second defendant IMAG does not assume non-existence of an actionable right. Because the court had relied, there's another case in the year 1948, the Saltman case. Here you can see it was held that the maintenance of secrecy according to the circumstances in any given case either rests on the principles of equity. That is to say, the application by the court of the need for conciseness in the course of conduct or by the common law action for breach of confidence, which is in effect a breach of contract. How it was a breach of contract? Because, no, I'll not, okay. Now here in case of IMAG, what had happened, that Ulfat Ali Khan, he had collected certain trade secret of Homag India because he was working there. And then he had passed on to that IMAAG. So IMAAG, he thought that I am free, I am not a party to it. So I do not have any confidential agreement or non-confidential agreement or NCA, non-competition agreement with HOMAG. So I am free. So he took all the information and then he started, you know, misappropriating the trade secret. But the court had found that even though there is no direct contract or breach of contract between first and third party, since it was found that he, the second party who had the privilege, who had the privy to collect the info trade secret and pass on to IMAAG. So in that case also, the trade secret or breach of trade or breach of confidence will prevail. And but the exception is that where under a license for the use of know-how, a licensee is in breach of a condition either expressed in any agreement or implied from conduct to maintain secrecy in respect of such know-how and fails to do so. In case of licensing agreement, the situation is little different than NDA or NCA or the employment agreement. These three kind of agreements are little different than the licensing agreement. So this is actually, these are the issues or these are the cases. I gave you only some example because there are our other speakers here and we will all together carry forward the session. I just gave you all these issues just to say that although India do not have a particularly codified law for protecting trade secret, but there are multiple of laws which are, you know, I should say commingling of laws which will help you to maintain your trade secret and as well as to obtain the remedy against any unfair adaptation, misappropriation or